And the leader never died because he said, I want to go and teach everyone to die. Because ultimately we have to die, then why bother about anything? If ultimately we are matter and being in a particular shape and in environment, if it becomes too unbearable, then death. Therefore, those who commit suicide and all have maybe that type of understanding. With death, we will be free from all our trouble. This is totally at one level, matter. But there are some who do not believe in matter. I mean, who believes in something exist which is subtler than matter. They believe in their jiva. They believe in the mind and intellect. They believe that the mind and intellect with all its samskar exist even after the death of the body. Even when the body falls down dead, something remains which doesn't die. So they believe in that existence of something subtler than the body. May not believe, may not understand the nature of that Atma, but only understand that there is something subtler than the body which exists. And many believe in that. And that is what generally people consider as Atma, and that they consider as going here, there, and we saw it, and all those ghosts and all stories are there around this subtler aspect. And it is also true because when the body, gross body, falls down dead, the mind, the intellect, and all the impressions which are gathered, they don't die. They remain. And that is the individuality which we have. When I say I, as a particular person or particular personality, that personality depends on the nature and structure of our mind and intellect. What type of thoughts I have, what type of feelings I have, that creates that personality. That also keeps on modifying and changing, but that creates that personality. That personality doesn't die. It then creates for itself another body. Just as the example of our mobile phone and the chip. That chip is the personality of that mobile. It contains the number, it contains all the samskar, all the incoming, outgoing, SMS, this, that, whatever one has used, what time and what, everything is noted there. It becomes troublesome also sometimes. Everyone knows. At home when the bill comes, others want to see. Kisko call kiya hai, kiska number hai. आप रोज इनको क्यों कॉल करते हो? So all this incoming, outgoing, everything is recorded. Suppose somebody says, I just remove that chip from this mobile and throw it away so that nobody knows and buy a new one, I will not get the bill. Still I will get the bill. Because the bill comes to that chip, doesn't come to the mobile. Similarly, the karma phala comes to our mind, doesn't come to our body. Whichever body we are, it will come. Tomorrow, if we are in a buffalo's body, it will come. Arey, aapka naam ka packet aa gaya hai. Even buffalo's body or any monkey body, whatever. Whatever karmas, because karmas are performed by the mind. Of course, we use the body, but the mind is the main doer, the thoughts and all. So they have performed karma, so the result also comes. So this mind and intellect, which forms our personality along with all the samskars of the past, is also not the supreme self, though it is alive because of the self. It is functioning because of the self. But it is also a limited entity, a limited structure, which is not the supreme self. It can be considered as jiva atma, not the supreme atma. So the atma is identified with deha. We consider deha as atma. Or it is identified with the jiva, an individuality formed by mind and intellect, or thoughts and our samskar means impressions. That is also not the supreme atma. But that also remains and travels as though from one body to another, from one experience to another. Even in this lifetime, it is the mind and intellect which gathers constantly experiences. It keeps on passing from one experience to other experience. So if we don't understand the sublime nature of that self, Bhagavan says, even if you take yourself to be the body, then you don't have to grieve because body will anyway fall down dead. Even if you take yourself to be the jivatma, then you don't have to grieve because it doesn't die, it takes up another body. Because if it leaves one body, it is born in another body. So athacha enam nitya jatam, even if you consider this atma as nitya jatam, constantly being born as a jiva, and nityam va manyase mritam, and constantly dying in a particular body, tathapi tvam mahabaho, even then, he mahabaho, naivam shochitam arhasi, you don't have to grieve like this. There is no need for you to grieve. There is no reason for you to grieve. You look at it very objectively, very clearly, and become free of that grief. See, for example, a child is crying for some toy is broken, or is lost some, or the balloon has bursted, or some things like that. The wise, the parents and all sometimes teach them, you don't have to grieve. We will get you another balloon. We'll get you another toy. That toy has anyway gone. It is not, it will not last forever. We give such wise statement, just like Bhagavad Gita. But when it comes to our own body, when it comes to our own life, we lose our wisdom. But the same argument is applicable for that also, because there is no difference. Just as a toy get destroyed, similarly this body also get destroyed. Just like our mobile phone get destroyed or we discard it, similarly body also get discarded. Just as the chip remains, the jivatma remains. Just as the electricity doesn't get affected, atma doesn't get affected by the whole process. So tathapi tvam mahabaho naivam shochitam arhasi, you don't have to grieve even for the jiva of Bhishma Pitamaha or Dronacharya or yourself or your brothers or your uncles or all those relatives, your friends who have assembled here. Don't grieve that they will die and totally be lost forever. No, they will be there. They will be there in some other form. And even later on he will say, even if you try to prevent what is going to happen, you won't be able to prevent it. You can't prevent the cycle of this world. It's like a tree which is growing. You cannot prevent the growth. It is growing. And as it grows, the previous stage gets destroyed and a new stage is born. Similarly, there are certain things which have to happen. They will anyway happen. In the 11th chapter also, Bhagavan shows him the Virat Roop. And in that Virat Roop, Arjuna sees the war already happened. He says, I will show you the future for you. War has already taken place. So those points we will see when we come to it. But here Bhagavan is saying that you don't have to grieve for that which is inevitable. So if a person dies, he will be born again. He says in the next verse, Jatasya hidruvo mrityuhu dhruvam janma mrtasya cha tasmad aparihāryerthe natvam shochitum arhasi jātasya hidruvo mrityuhu dhruvam janma mrtasya cha tasmad aparihāryerthe natvam shochitum arhasi. If a person is born, if there is a birth of a particular personality and individual. Jatasya hi dhruvo mrityuhu. If a person is born, then the death is certain. There is certain death for the one who is born, because that is the very nature of this world. Birth, along with it, brings its death also. Just as we buy a medicine, it also contains that expiry date. Quite frightening sometimes, actually. They should not write such expiry thing on medicine, but what to do? Expiry date is there. Ne? So, and when do they write that expiry? The time when they manufacture it. Similarly, the time when this body is manufactured, the expiry is also written on it. Jatasya hi dhruvo mrityuhu, we cannot prevent. We may try our level best. We postpone it. We do all sorts of things. Plastic surgery, face lifting, weight lifting. So many things we do. We can postpone the process or we try to change it, but we can't prevent it. Because jatasya hi dhruvo mrityu. As we live in this world, we are moving towards death only, death of this body. And every time we celebrate our birthday and all, we are going towards it only. So jatasya hi dhruvo mrityuhu. So it is inevitable. But very important and interesting thing is ki dhruvam janma mrutasya cha, that if one is dead, is born again. See, now one may say that, oh, I have not seen that person, where is he? Born again need not be on this. This is a very vast, vast cosmos. And not only a person may be born here, but may be born anywhere else. It's like a person who goes to sleep. Nobody can predict what type of dream that person is dreaming. With our scientific equipment and all, we may know that he is dreaming, rapid eye movement and all these things. We know that this person is dreaming. But what exactly is dreaming, we don't know. And if one dream ends, another dream begins. Sometimes in one night, people dream some 7-8 dreams, one after another. And some dreams are interesting, some are not. Sometimes people wake up from a dream and they want to go back to the same dream. Once Mullah Nasruddin, he woke up from a dream. And he told his wife, I want to go into the same dream. He said, what happened? He says, in my dream that person came and was returning my money which he had borrowed. But before he could give, I woke up, so I want to go back and take it. So, what dream world we will go, we don't know. And that is, and when we go to the world, what is true and what is real is my own presence there. I am there and the world is there. And whichever world we go, it looks quite familiar to us. So when a person dies in this world, where that personality will go depends on so many factors, on the laws of karma, on laws of karma. Choice is not there. On the laws of karma, means depending on the samskar which are there in our mind, that personality takes up different types of forms and goes. See this, many people, they have, in our religion, we believe and it is there, this reincarnation and all. But there are some who do not accept or do not believe in it. But even if you logically look at it, it seems very, very convincing and logical. One is that if we don't accept the laws of karma, which is also not only based on what we have done now, but it is based on what one has done in the past, if law of karma is not accepted, then the whole concept of cause and effect will go haywire. Then we will have to say that a person suffers or dies as a child or has got some in one